So here's your agenda for Virtual Class 4. We start with a listening in Activity 10.1, where you need to erase incorrect information and answer questions. Activity 10.2, you need to look at the language key for could and be able to, which we will look at as well in this presentation, and then answer Activity 5 and 6. 10.3 is a worksheet, which I will show you after the presentation. And finally, 10.4 is a My On Reading and quiz about the world's wackiest history.
So, boys and girls, here is the presentation that we use in today's virtual class. Unfortunately, there are a few technical problems, which meant that I only managed to record the first 2 minutes, which is a terrible shame, because we had some wonderful participation from students such as Borges. Your participation was excellent in the little game we played before we started this presentation. But never mind. Let's begin to have a look at could or be able to. To talk about our past ability, we use could, but was or were able to is also possible. She could read when she was 3, or she was able to read when she was 3. In spoken English, we are less likely to use was able to. It sounds more formal. As you see in these sentences, we're talking about general ability, things that we could do at any time in the past. In the virtual class, you gave me a few examples, which were wonderful, and we'll move on. When we're talking about specific occasions in the past, we can't use could, so we use was or were able to. We can also use managed or succeeded in their place. So let's look at the example. I was able to get some really good bargains in the sale. Not, I could get some really good bargains in the sale. The sale was in a specific occasion. I could run the Boston Marathon last year. Does not talk about ability. I was able to run the Boston Marathon last year is the correct way to talk about past ability in that specific situation. In our examples towards the bottom, we look at using managed. After climbing for several hours, we managed to get to the top of the mountain has the same meaning as after climbing for several hours, we were able to get to the top of the mountain. We can't say we could get to the top of the mountain. We use was or were able to talk about things that were difficult to achieve. We use could more for things that are simple. But something that caused trouble, something that was difficult to achieve, we use was or were able to. And I like the example at the bottom. After Titanic had sunk, nearly 700 people were able to survive. Both could and be able to can be used to say we were not capable of doing something on a specific occasion. So we'll go back to climbing as an example. In spite of climbing for hours, we couldn't get to the top of the mountain is a perfectly acceptable sentence. In spite of climbing for hours, we weren't able to get to the top of the mountain is also. And again, in the virtual class, you gave me some lovely examples. Now we had a look at some pictures. And we had to fill the gaps in. So Jim, here we put could run very fast when he was 18 years old, or was able to run very fast when he was 18 years old. Both of those would have been okay. Shania Twain, something, sing very well before she lost her voice at 45 years old. Here we put could. Before she was 45 is not a specific time, it is before a specific time. And number 3, he's something drive a car when he turns 18 years old. Here we're talking in the future because he's not 18 yet, so we're going to say will be able to. Number 4, Daniel, and we're going to put can ride a horse easily, showing that it's not difficult to do now that he is 20 years old. So now we're talking in the present. Can. Number 5, my mother said I was able to talk very early or could talk very early at only 14 months old. We are going to say was able to because it is a specific time. My baby will be able to walk by 1 year old because she is very ambitious. We'll talk about the future if we're guessing that in the picture that baby is less than 1 year old. Or if we think the baby is past 1 year old, we can put it in past tense. My baby was able to walk by 1 year old because she's very ambitious. I would accept that as well, but the best answer, I guess, would be in the future. Number 7, she has just turned 4 and she something play the violin and the piano. Okay, can and is able to is perfectly fine. He is only 10 years old, but he thinks he, if we're talking about the present, can change the world, or in the future, will be able to change the world. You can put could in there, but that is talking more about possibilities than abilities. Ethan, something, buy a house by the time he turns 35. Again, we're looking in the future. Will be able to buy a house by the time he turns 35. Jonathan is 6 years old and he can say the alphabet backward. My mother something wear so many beautiful clothes when she was a slim 18-year-old girl. We're going to use was able to, talking about the past, a specific time when she was 18. Finally, 12, I something travel all over the world after I turn 60 years old, when I retire. After I turn 60 years old, she's talking about the future, so we're going to use will be able to. Here is your activity 10.3. The first part, all you have to do is complete the sentences with one word. The second part is multiple choice. Choose the correct word or phrase to go in the spaces. And lastly, I'd like you to create an example sentence where could is the only option and one where be able to is the only option. Remember, could is the only option when we're emphasizing that something was very easy to do. Once you've done that, we just have a Mayon reading and then you have finished for the week. Again, I apologize that we don't have the video, an unfortunate technical error. If anybody did manage to record the class, please let me know and we can try to get it uploaded. Otherwise, we just have very fond memories of the 40 minutes we spent together. And until next week, I can say goodbye, take care, and enjoy these lovely activities. Bye-bye.